Service to God, trust in Him. Romans 15. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, I glory in Christ Jesus in my service to God. I will not venture to speak of anything except what Christ has accomplished through me in leading the Gentiles, which is everyone, to obey God through the power of the Spirit. I fully proclaim the gospel of Christ. It has always been my ambition to preach the gospel of Christ, where Christ was and is not known, so that I would not be building on someone else's foundation. Rather, as it is written, those who were not told about Him will see, and those who have not heard will understand. If we live, we live to the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. So, whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. For this reason, Christ died and returned to life, so that He might be the God of both the dead and the living. You then, why do you judge your brother, which is anyone, or why do you look down on your brother, which is anyone? For we will all stand before God's judgment seat at the end, as it is written. As surely as I live, says the Lord, every knee will bow down before me, every tongue will confess to God. So that each of us will give an account of himself to God. Therefore, let us stop passing judgment on one another. Instead, make up your mind not to put any stumbling block or obstacle in your brother or sister's way. As one who is in the Lord Jesus, of righteousness, peace, joy, and in the Holy Spirit. Because anyone who serves Christ in this way is pleasing to God and approved by men, because of the grace God gave me to be a minister of Christ Jesus to the Gentiles, which is everyone, with the priestly duty of proclaiming the gospel of God, so that the Gentiles, which everyone, might become an offering acceptable to God, God sanctified by the Holy Spirit. Amen, amen. Thank you. sick today. Anyway, and excuse me on the song, I didn't have no time on it. And I have severe allergies, so excuse me there as well. And I work in my sermon, excuse me, I work in my sermon all week. So I keep adding to it, so excuse me there as well. I just screamed.
take my youngest son to the walk-in clinic right away. He has kidney infection. And we were in a hurry, so he had on his everyday clothes. He had on playing with his puppy. And got dirty, but he has a lot of nice clothes. It was hurry when we went. Anyway, thank goodness for the walk-in clinic. Anyway, all I cared about was getting him to the doctor. I've taken my kids off my membership at the Ripplex. They played on their tablets and laptop computers. I've given them 3 warnings to work out, swim, or go to the gym's game room, but they kept doing it, playing on their tablet and stuff, and their laptop computer instead. So I've taken them off my membership, but they could still use my passes if they ever want to come, so you understand me there as a parent. I'm sure you would have done the same thing as well. Anyway, my youngest son and I are hanging out together all weekend since my youngest daughter's gone out of town for the weekend. Anyway, as a person, I was due for a good cry. I haven't cried for a while, so I had a good one. Mom is dying of terminal cancer. It feels like I'm going through it again. Myself. I mean, she is my mother. So now I feel relieved some since I've cried, so you understand me there as well. We're going to see her again this month. And most likely will probably be the last time I'll see her alive. Anyway, like I said, I can use your prayers. My mom's name is Gertrude. She's dying of terminal cancer. Thank you. Okay, now this week's children's lesson is FAITH, F-A-I-T-H. Excuse me, like I said, my allergies are severe this year. I got a scratchy throat and a runny nose, and my eyes are watery, excuse me. Now, faith means belief and trust. So who or what comes to mind? As we go through life, we should lean on belief and trust in God, our Heavenly Father, no matter what it is. We must ask WWJD, what would Jesus do for doing it and do the right thing for through him, no matter how hard it may be. He helps us grow in and through him and be like him and be like him. And live our lives as he did, as Jesus did. Remember that. So we can inherit eternal life with him in his kingdom. Amen, amen. So remember that. Now let's pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our trespasses, and forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Okay, I feel support to say this. I always want to thank OSF. I also want to thank OSF Hospital that's affiliated with the Riverplex. They help a lot of people too, so thank you there as well. Okay, now I've been teaching you. You get tired of hearing this, but this is also for the newcomers. 2 Peter 2, where a man's a slave to whoever's mastered you, you are a slave to. And Christ chose, appointed, apostles, prophets, high priests. Christ is coming again. Christ is coming again. Amen, amen. At the end of time. And Mount Zion, where us righteous will live with him in his new holy city forever in his kingdom. And heaven and discipled in James 2, that good deeds and actions work together, and your faith is make it plead by what you do. Ask WWJD, what would Jesus do for doing it? Do the right things in and through him. Seek glory, honor, and immortality. He will give eternal life with him in his kingdom. And be careful, buy it from people who do other scriptures besides the Holy Bible. 2 Peter 3:16, to their own destruction, which is hell. People do witchcraft, murmurers, enchanters, seduction, mortal, idolaters, harlots, raiders, perverse, swindlers, grumblers, mutilators of the flesh, debauchers, scoffers, delusions, mockers, jackals, rebels, and liars. Okay, excuse me, like I said, I got severe allergies, so try to cope with me. Be accepted and offered to my altar, and I will adore my to me and lead all the ships of Tarshish. Bring your sons from afar with the silver and gold to the honor of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has endowed with splendor. Excuse me, the wind's picking up. Hope it's not borrowing my camcorder. Excuse me if it does. Foreigners will build your walls and their kings will serve you. Though in anger I struck you, in favor I will show you compassion. Your gates will always stand open. They will never be shut day or night. So that men may bring you the wealth of the nations, their kings, led in triumphal procession. For the nation or kingdom that will not serve you will perish, die, and in hell it will be utterly ruined. The glory of Lebanon will come to you, the pine, the fir, and the cypress together. To dwell in place of my sanctuary, I will glorify the place of my feet. The sons of your oppressors will come bowing for you. All who despise you will bow down at your feet. And will call you the city of the Lord, the city of the Lord, the Zion, Mount Zion, of the Holy One of Israel. Amen, amen. Stay on this. Although you have been forsaken and hated, with no one traveling through, I will make you the everlasting pride and the joy of all generations. You will drink the milk of nations and be nursed at the royal breast. And you will know that I, the Lord, am your Savior, your Savior, your Redeemer, the mighty one of Jacob. Instead of bronze, I will bring you gold, instead of place of iron, instead of wood. I will bring you bronze and iron, place of stones. I will make peace, peace, your governor. I will make peace, peace, your governor. Excuse me. And righteousness, your ruler, and righteousness will be your ruler. Amen, amen. It's at the end of time. You will call your wall salvation, salvation of your gates. Praise, praise, praise. The sun, the sun, the sun will no more be your light by day, no, nor will the brightness of the moon shine on you, no. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, everlasting light, everlasting light. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun, as you live, will never set. People be righteous.
one grabs me, Lord, be greater. Greater than, well, pretty much anything.
Okay, we haven't said this in a while.
It's part of the chorus here. Here's magnifying.
Go to Matthew 13, start right there.
Double-S-C-I-C.
Jesus Christ parables me. Then he left the crowd and went into the house. His disciples came to him and said, explain us the parable of the wheat and the field. He answered, the one who sows the good seed, this is not a man which is Jesus Christ. The field is the world, and the good seed stands for the sons of the kingdom. The weeds are the sons of the evil one. And the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of age, and the harvesters are the angels. As the weeds are pulled up and burnt to the fire, so will be at the last stage, the last stage, the last stage. The Son of Man, Jesus, will send out his angels, and they will weed out all of his kingdom, everything and everyone that causes sin. And now who do evil, evil, evil. Throw them into the fiery furnace, which is hell, where they be weeping and gnashing their teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father in heaven. He who has an ear, let him hear. Amen, amen. It's going to happen. At the end of time, here it comes again. Let's be ready. Let's be prepared. One another. I have been quiet all the way around. Some point. minister of Christ Jesus to the Gentiles, which is everyone, with the priestly duty of proclaiming the gospel of God, so that the Gentiles, which is everyone, might become an offering, acceptable to God, sanctified by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, I glory in Christ Jesus in my service to God. I will not venture to speak of anything except what Christ has accomplished for me in leading the Gentiles, which is everyone, to obey God by what I have said and done, by the power of signs and miracles through the power of the Spirit. So from Jerusalem all the way around heaven, I have fully proclaimed the gospel of Christ. It has always been my mission to preach the gospel where Christ was not known, so that I want to be built on someone else's foundation rather than those who were not told about him will see, and these who have not heard will understand. This is why I have often been hindered from coming to you.
to see those guys in Springfield.
Bring them in.
Friday, March 10th.
Okay. I'm losing my partner. Excuse me.
New music. Here's
no, I'm just a speaker.
It's called Fearless.
That's a simple nation relations. Star verse 19, obvious. Sexual morality, impurity, debauchery, idolatry, and witchcraft. Hatred, discord, jealousy, disarray, self-ambition, desertion, faction, envy, drunkenness, orgies, and the like. I warned you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Self-control, self-control. Against such there is no law. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified me to the cross, and I'm dying. Passions, with his passions and desires, since we're led by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Let us not become consumed from and envying each other. Amen. Okay, another one I want to read. So my marker's in the way, so he's going to stay. Washington, Illinois, got here a few years ago. Me and my organization. people, the 13-year-old boy is missing a pizza. Now pray for Illinois and surrounding areas from storms and tornadoes Tuesday for the victims. Those are my allergies. North Carolina's dam, severe erosion, 200,000 people has been evacuated for the victims from weeks ago. Southern California, major storms and flooded from weeks ago. Violence flood killed 40, affected 1.6 million people from weeks ago. Be singing sometimes.